Hey guys, what's up? Today I have some art hacks for the broke artist. Excuse me? You don't have to be broke to watch this. Who's she calling broke? They're more thrifty things that we can all do, and it makes us feel like we've got a lot of art supplies and we can do some really cool things with what we have. Guess I'll check it out. So let's just hop on into this and get started. Don't have a paint palette? Hey, it's okay. No need to buy one. You can just use a paper plate. All right, let me guess. You don't have a paper plate. Don't worry, I've got you. All you need to do is tape a piece of wax paper to a piece of cardboard. I just use masking tape. It comes off easily, and I can reuse the cardboard after that. Nothing soaks in. You can make whatever colors you want. Yeah. Do you want good paintbrushes that you can actually afford? Do you want multiple sizes? You should consider buying a pack of makeup brushes. You can get a pack for $5 to $10, and the quality is just as good, if not better, than paintbrushes that you buy in a store. I bought this set from Wish for maybe $3. It took about a month and a half to come, but they're really great. I love them. Do you have old hairspray lids, candle containers, beauty sample containers? Save them. Fill them with paint. Acrylic works, watercolor works, just add your water later. Perfect storage. And it's free. All right, guys, here's a personal favorite. You should totally invest in a white charcoal pencil. What? You don't use charcoal? So these puppies can really bring finishing touches on your work, and you can layer it over Copic marker, colored pencil, watercolor, a pencil sketch, even charcoal. You know, the possibilities are endless. I love to use it for gouache and watercolor, doing highlight. Say I made the face too dark, you just, not on my own face. I believe this was like $1.79 at Blix, but you could probably find it cheaper on Amazon. Need to blend large areas in a painting? Try a sponge, or an old rag, even an old sock works. I get so many of you commenting on my videos saying, Miranda, I just bought this really expensive sketchbook, but I'm too afraid to use it. I don't want to waste it. Dude, why'd you buy it? To get over that fear, you need to invest in a good eraser, something that won't shred your paper and you can lift your lines very well. I recommend a Need eraser. This one was, I think, $1.79 at Blix, and it's by Prismacolor. Can you see that? I don't think it's focusing. And if you don't want to spend $1.79 on an eraser of all things, you can really just pay 99 cents for this cute little thing. Look how adorable this is. Ah, I love cute things. If you want to achieve a lot of shades in your drawing, but you don't have a pencil set, just grab a mechanical pencil laying around your house and go buy a soft lead pencil that's darker lead. Saves you about 9 or 10 bucks. I don't know about you, but I don't pay for pencil cases. I steal them. No, but in all reality, I use makeup bags instead because I usually get them for free in the mail. I have sensitive skin, so I get Clinique lotion all the time for my face, and they're always sending me all these little free samples, and I reuse the containers for watercolors and gouache. I reuse their makeup bags for art supplies. So this is where I put all my art supplies, and I have not paid for a pencil case or anything in years. I've just been doing this, or I'll just use little zip pouches that other people give me. If you use Amazon, this is a really, really good one for you. There is this website called Vipon.com. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right. I'll put it on the screen somewhere, and I'll leave a link in the description below. But basically, it's this website in which you can order certain things on Amazon. Now, granted, not every single thing on Amazon is available to you, only up-and-coming things. So if you're interested in testing like new things, sometimes art suppliers will put their products on this site. You can actually order the art product at a really, really reduced rate in exchange for a review. Now, due to Amazon's terms, they can't actually force you to do a review, but it's kind of this respect thing where they trust that maybe you'd be nice enough to leave one. And I mean, I usually do when I get stuff from there because, I mean, it's nice, right? And everybody loves Amazon reviews. We all use them. So if you are interested in that, sometimes they have like crafting stuff, art supplies, whatnot. They even have like clothes and kitchen stuff and really cool things. I used to use it all the time. So it's worth checking out. And yeah, as I said, I'll put the link below. Man, the hack I was most excited about, I was on my way home, gonna go pick the thing up so I could show you guys, and I forgot. So pretend this is aerosol hairspray. You cannot use this kind of hairspray in a spray bottle. You gotta use it out of a spray can, guys. But if you are doing some sort of sketch or charcoal drawing, you can spray this, keep a good distance away from your artwork, and it will seal your stuff in and prevent it from smudging. My art instructor had us do this all the time in high school, and it worked like a charm. You really don't have to go buy fixative. I mean, unless you want like archival quality, whatever. This works great, but I will repeat, do not use this kind. Don't use a spray bottle. You gotta use an aerosol can. You need more of a mist. You don't wanna go too heavy. You know what I'm saying? So bummed I forgot to get that on my way home. I was going to spray this for you and show you how it works, but you can just try it yourself if you have some at your house. Alrighty guys, those are my art hacks for the broke or thrifty artist. I hope you enjoyed this video. Once again, I'm so sorry that I didn't get to do this hairspray demo with you guys. I drove 30 minutes to go out and get what I needed today, and I did not go out and get what I actually went out for. Anyway, I hope you find these hacks helpful. These are things I do all the time, especially the paper plate one. I don't really care. I don't need the most expensive thing out there. I'll use whatever. Who cares, right? I hope this makes you feel like you can expand upon what you have as an artist. I know a lot of people comment, okay, these art supplies are cool, but it doesn't really fit my budget, so what can I do? So you really do have a lot of options. You don't need the most expensive paints, the most expensive markers, any of that stuff, but sometimes just buying simple things like better erasers or the white charcoal pencil, these really make your pieces pop. For instance, I used that pencil in this drawing here, and it really helped. It really brought her face to life. Sometimes art can be a really expensive hobby, but it doesn't have to be. You can use what you have. Sometimes I think people get caught up in the price tags, but I'm just gonna be real with you guys. The art is in your fingertips. The skill sets you have, that's all in you. That's in your brain. That's the skills that you have learned over time, and you are conveying that through your fingertips. So don't let people tell you that just because you can't afford something doesn't mean you're a good artist. Like, yeah, right. You're a good artist, and you know you are. Okay, so for the comment of the day, tell me something thrifty that you do as an artist so that everybody else can kind of like go to the comments and read what you do too, and we can all kind of share ideas, and it's always fun getting inspiration from other people, right? If you are new to the art family, feel free to thumbs up this video and subscribe. I have new videos multiple times a week. Alrighty guys, have a good day, and thanks for watching.